try to break the tension a little bit. Becca keeps it light. So we've all seen a little bit of a video about Becca, but the great thing is there are people across this country that are watching live right now on what's taking place. You know, please, as a reminder, make sure you send in some questions. I'm sure that we'd love to hear what's going on out there. But the other piece is I think you got some raving fans back in Encinitas IT department. If you guys are watching, and I know you are, a little more bandwidth down to Encinitas, please. Apparently there are laptops open up all over the place. And in fact, you've got some customers who are raving fans who somehow tracked down my email. And I thought I'd share a couple with you. It's kind of funny, you gotta love our customers. It didn't come in as mission-inspired feedback, darn it. In my long history of coffee drinking, Becca may well be the best barista I've ever seen. Every drink that Becca makes is a work of art unto itself. Not only do they taste great, but the design she uses on her espresso drinks are a thing of beauty. Sometimes I feel guilty drinking them. They look so awesome. So that was Tom out at your store. And then this one got me. My gal and I have traveled the world as true coffee snobs. We sometimes plan our trips and where we stay based on good espresso. Although Melbourne and Italy are hard to beat, we've never had a better domestic coffee drink than the little jewels of deliciousness that Becca crafts for us, Fleet and Mary. So it's amazing when we have these contacts to our customers and the impacts that we make in their lives every single morning and every day, that they make the impact. So without further ado, Becca.
Okay, thank you, Sam, for that nice introduction, and I guess we'll get started. All right, so thank you, judges, for being here. I've been really looking forward to this, and I'm looking forward to the drinks I'm going to be making for you today. And I'm excited to be working with our Arabian Mocha Java blend. It's a blend that you can really trace back to kind of the history of coffee, kind of when coffee traveled from the Arabian Peninsula down to the Indo-Pacific area. And it's just a classic blend, and it works amazingly well as espresso, and I've been really excited to use it. I kind of want to highlight the Arabian Mocha Sinani coffee in it. The Sinani is a natural process coffee that comes from Yemen on the Arabian Peninsula there. And natural process means that essentially when you pick the coffee chair, you're leaving that fruit, kind of the red fruit, on the bean while it's drying. So that enables it to kind of impart all of those fruity, kind of pungent, sometimes wild, winey flavors to the bean. And Sinani, a lot of times at our store we'll do kind of like blind press pot tastings, or we like to call them guest pot press pot. And so many times people will pick the Sinani and I'll taste it, and like a few times I've guessed, oh, that's totally aged Sumatra. And then when I realize that it's not, I'm like, what in the world? How was I so far off? But then I learned also that when you do natural processed coffees, keeping the fruit on there, it kind of preserves it in a way. So the farmers, they can kind of keep some beans on the back shelf and just kind of sell them when they need it. So essentially, there is kind of like an aged component in the Sinani. Like, you can come across a batch of our Sinani that could have like three different crop years represented. So it really does give it kind of the aged element and kind of a more wild note. So that's kind of a wild card of a coffee to work with. But then you add the Java to it, and it makes it excellent for espresso because it's a lot more kind of even keeled, more consistently performing, and it really rounds out the body of the espresso. So I'm going to start by pulling you the espresso shots. I have beans that were roasted on Thursday, on the 27th, so they've had a few days for kind of like the gases and everything to kind of mellow out a bit, but that flavor, that pungency, and the richness is still very much there. So we'll get started with the shots. What you're going to taste essentially is, like with the Sinani, it's going to give you that like rich pungency right away. And then with kind of flavors of kind of those like old world fruits, like you're going to get definitely that wininess and some kind of like fig and prune, and just, and then later on as you let the shot kind of linger in your mouth, you're going to get hit with kind of that subtle like bittersweet cocoa notes to it.
Against the weather dawning, over the sea.
All right, I'll start with
my father said what I had become.
Then a show. There you are. Enjoy, and then you guys become right up.
outside I look lived in, like the moons in a shrine. How am I forgiven? Oh,
next I'm going to be making you the cappuccino course. And one of the great things about Arabian Mocha Java as espresso is that it has that rich pungency that's really gonna kind of cut through the milk and still be the star in a cappuccino. And so you take kind of those kind of subtle, like real dark, kind of bittersweet, like baking cocoa notes that are in this single espresso, and then you add milk to it, and it's gonna bring definitely like a more milky, kind of semi-sweet, chocolatey and creaminess notes to it. So let me get started with the cappuccinos. I'm gonna start with Tamara and Rochelle first, and then Loretta and Doug, you guys will be next. Sad keeps moving, so I wandered around. I fell in love with the burden.
Without knowing,
back. Here we go. Yeah. Thank you.
This is how I tell it. Long. One Sunday morning, one sun is gone.
The last course, I'm going to be making you essentially a con panna, which is essentially a really tiny cappuccino. And then on the side, there's going to be some fresh blueberries and a little bit of dark chocolate. And kind of the inspiration behind this was to really just take those already existing flavors in Arabian Mocha Java and just to kind of exaggerate them and kind of expound on them a little bit. So I have the blueberries to kind of emulate that wininess, that pungency, and that rich kind of fruitiness that it has, and then the dark chocolate to kind of mimic those kind of cocoa notes that come out in the end. So I want to instruct you, and I'll remind you, but to eat a blueberry or two, and then take a tiny little corner off of the chocolate, and then sip the cortado. And so I'll get started on those for you guys.
Thank you.
for you. I hope you enjoyed all of them. And that's time. Thank you. Thanks.
Oh. You did it.
Yeah, I guess so.
So how do you feel?
Oh, pretty good. I'm kind of, I think I'm more like shaken up now than I was right before, but it's okay. I feel good.
It was very beautiful to watch.
Thank you.
And I think we all enjoyed it. So what was your inspiration for your signature drink?
Well, I was kind of working through a lot, trying to come up with something new for that. But then I had all of these like extravagant things, like crushing up blueberries and doing all this stuff. But essentially what I found that worked the most is really just focusing on the coffee and letting it be the star and kind of taking those flavors and working with that.
Could you see somebody ordering that in a restaurant after a meal? Was that a vision?
Yeah, I would hope so. That'd be cool. Yeah,
that's what I was thinking. What a nice presentation, right?
Thank you.
Right, okay. So this is kind of the accumulation of this whole process, and you were mm-hmm. talking about each part of it was different for you. So mm-hmm. how different was this when you're finally on stage?
Yeah, I mean, just being here, like coming up for the workshop, and then even right now has been an absolute dream come true. And like, I mean, I even get like, I don't know, a little emotional thinking about it, but it's been just so great to meet everyone. And
well, yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So I'm going to, we have a question. Oh, so we need Becca back. We have a question.
So we have somebody who is salivating over several of the signature drinks that they see today, and they wanted mm-hmm. to know.
Well, we might have to go through a little, I don't know, corporate to kind of allow blueberries, I guess. maybe if you come in like during the afternoon on slow time or something, but.
And then the head judge, Brian Swinfernell, does he taste every drink or just sample here and there?
I believe, yeah, he tastes every drink because he wants to get like an overall kind of view of all the drinks together.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks.
Thank you.